And ever since then, I've been able to identify that that has been Natanz. Natanz nuclear station in Iran. That means there's a lot of intelligence that has gone in, and they have found out that all these new amigos, and those are hawks, the work is here. Natanz. The nuclear facility behind the mountain. And what amazed me, when the Lord spoke me about this one, when the two missiles come, and those missiles must also be nuclear missiles, it will be there.
Hi, precious one, today is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. You are welcome to prayer line. Precious one, you don't have to be a scientist. You don't have to be a prophet in order to believe what you just heard. Because if you've been watching the news and even watching some of my videos, you realize that I've been showing videos about, you know, documentaries and news about the fact that Israel is planning to even strike Iran as early as spring. And every time you watch the news, the tension between the United States and Iran and Israel and Iran is always, you know, just escalating, it's just increasing, always tension. So, you know, just take this prophecy into heart and know that very soon these prophecies will happen. Because already, signs are already shown. If you just go to Fox News, go to Yahoo, just watch the news and you will know what's going on. Israel, the Israelis have emphatically declared that they are planning to strike Iran as early as spring, April, May, because they believe that the Iranians, if they are given too much time, to get the nuclear bombs and all those things, so they want to make sure they destroy their nuclear facilities as early as spring. They are trying to get Americans involved to support them in striking Iran. However, the Americans are hesitant under the Obama administration into doing that. They want to do a diplomatic talk with Iran. And I believe that the basic fear of Obama administration is that he knows that the election is coming very soon by November, and he doesn't want to take anybody into war zone or conflict because he believes it will affect his second term in office. But I believe that once Obama is elected as the next president, for him to continue with his second term in office, I believe that this thing will not be a problem. The only reason why he's hesitant is because he wants to make sure that he wins his second term in office, and he doesn't want to bring any controversial topics like going to war and striking Iran and all those things right now. However, Israel wants to go ahead and do it because they know that their country is at stake, because the Iranian has made it public that they want to wipe out the Israelis. So the Israelis want to protect themselves, because once the Iranians get their nuclear bombs, they know that they are going to wipe them out. And so these are all prophecies. These are all, we are living a prophetic timeline. My question to you is that, how ready are you? One of the things I want you to know is that once Israel strikes Iran, the world, I believe, will never be the same. What I mean is that, one, it's going to affect gas prices. And already, many of the nations of the world are going through economic decline, economic meltdown. The European nations, for instance, they are falling apart. From Greece to Portugal, no, most of the countries are falling apart. They cannot even build themselves out or hold themselves together. And now, most of the European nations are dependent on Iran for oil. And now Iran is going to be bombed, and it's going to affect oil prices. It's just going to make the economy much more worse and life unbearable for a lot of people. Secondly, it's going to affect us directly or indirectly. Gas prices are going to go up. Already, people in this country are going through tough times. We have 49 million Americans who are living in poverty line. One out of every six people you see is living in poverty line. We have almost 23 million Americans who are out of jobs, seeking for jobs, cannot find one, who have bachelor's, master's, doctorate, and still cannot find jobs. Life is just difficult. The nation is right now in almost trillions of dollars in debt, and then going to add gas prices and conflict in the Middle East, it's going to cause commotion and confusion all over the world. Already, countries like China and Russia are solely dependent on Iran for their gas, and so that's why they are not willing to put tough sanctions on Iran. So imagine when Iran is being bombed by Israel, and Americans try to back Israel, because once Israel bombs Iran, the Iranians or some of the Arab nations will try to retaliate by attacking Israel, and the Americans will be forced to step in to defend Israel. Now, at the same time, countries like Russia and China are dependent on Iran for oil, for gas. So they will also want to step in and protect Iran, Russia, and China. So that's how we are seeing it, that it could even, it may lead to a third world war, or it will bring chaos in the world. Precious one, the world is coming to an end. The world is coming to an end. You better get ready for Jesus Christ. He's coming. The King of Glory is coming. Our Kinsman Redeemer, Jesus, is coming. Do you understand? Get yourself ready. If you don't know Jesus, accept him now as your Lord and personal Savior, because time is running out. We are living in a prophetic time clock, prophetic timeline. Things are happening so quickly. And I'm talking to Christians who are still sleeping and playing church and playing religion and playing tradition and playing hypocrisy Christianity, lukewarmness Christianity, are building churches instead of building the kingdom of God. Please wake up. Those days are over. Jesus is coming. He is coming for a holy church. The Bible says that judgment begins in the house of God. Jesus is coming for a holy church. The Bible says that without holiness, nobody can see God. You can't be 1 foot in the Lord and 1 foot in the world. You'll be left behind. You will be left behind to go to the tribulation. And you'll be forced to take the mark of the beast. So please, be serious now and worship God in truth and in spirit. And don't be distracted by the vain vanities of this world. But let your eyes be fixed on Christ and worship him in truth and in spirit. Go through the narrow door and allow yourself to be cleansed from all filthiness, all impurity. This is the time you have to begin to seek after God. Don't worship man. Don't worship your bishop, your archbishop, and the pastors. No. Worship Jesus in truth and in spirit, because he is the only way. He's the only truth. He's the only one. Life. Jesus is the only way, truth, and life. No one has access to the Father except through our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the time for you to be passionate about the things of God and worship God with everything in you, all your mind, body, soul, and spirit, your strength, your mind, your will. Worship him in truth and in spirit so that you may get rewards in heaven. You understand? This is a wake-up call. And if you are hearing the sound of my voice and you don't know Jesus, please, this is the day you have to confess him into your life and tell him to come and forgive you of your sins and give you eternal life. He will come and save you. Today he's knocking at the door of your heart. Life is too short. Life is very fragile. If you meet Michael Jackson or Steve Jobs, ask them, and they'll let you know that life is short. You may attain the wealth, fame, popularity like Don Colenius and everything. Yes, so you will die. Everybody will die. Everybody will one day die. But are you prepared to meet your maker? Every one of us will one day stand before him to be judged. And if you are judged and you didn't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, and you didn't know worship him in truth and in spirit, then you'll be cast into the lake of fire. But if you knew Jesus Christ and you worship him in truth and in spirit, and your sins were covered by the blood, then you will have eternal life. Today, ask yourself, are you ready? If Jesus comes today, would you make it? If you are to die today, would you make it? Heaven is real and hell is real. You have heaven to gain and hell to avoid, or hell to shun. Please wake up. Make up your decision of serving God in truth and spirit today. Make up your mind of accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior today, because this world is certainly coming to an end. By the end of February, things will be just going down, 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 down. And no, the worst is yet to be experienced. As much as we are, the Bible says that in the earth, arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon us. Is it upon the face of the earth? Darkness will cover the face of the earth. Darkness is going to cover the face of, things are going to become increasingly difficult. Distress of nations, rumors of wars, earthquakes and commotion, confusion. And watch out for high gas prices. Watch out for food shortage. That is my word of advice to you. Watch out for high prices, gas prices. Watch out for also this war with Iran, which can lead to third world war. And watch out for food shortage. And the only security is in Jesus Christ. Anyone who calls on the name of our Lord Jesus will be saved. Today, please call upon him. Ask him to come into your life. That's how you do it. If you want Jesus Christ to come into your life so you can have eternal life, just tell him, Heavenly Father, in the name of your Son Jesus Christ, I accept that I'm a sinner. Forgive me of my sins. Cleanse me and wash me with the precious blood of Jesus. Jesus, please come and live in me and have your way in my life. Today, I surrender my life to you. Save me and give me eternal life. If you pray this prayer out of sincerity, then believe that you have been saved and now you're a new creature. Get a Bible, begin to believe, read it, obey the commandment of God, and find a Bible-believing church and begin to go. Precious one, this is not the time to play church and religion and traditions and serve human beings. This is the time for you to worship Jesus in truth and in spirit, because he is coming very, 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 very soon. This world is coming to an end. And very soon, the trumpet will be sounding in the heavens, in the clouds. Our Lord Jesus Christ will be coming with his holy angels. The Bible makes us to understand that the dead in Christ who died, our relatives, our friends, our loved ones, the Christians who died, will resurrect. And those who are living, who also are living for Jesus and know Jesus Christ as their Lord and personal Savior, will also be caught up with them. And then after that, the great tribulation will come to the face of the earth. Right now, we have tribulations going on. Whenever you hear about wars, it is tribulation. You hear about earthquakes, tribulation. You hear about flooding, it is tribulation. When you hear about rumors of wars and volcano, tornadoes, people losing their jobs, global economic meltdown, these are all little tribulations. After the rapture, the great tribulation, the great Jacob's trouble will hit the face of the earth. And the man of peace, the Antichrist, will come in and try to deceive people and tell them he's bringing peace. And then he'll reveal his main identity. And now the Bible says that man cannot buy or sell until they have the identification mark. That is the 666 on their forehead or on the palm of their hands. You cannot trade. You cannot buy. You cannot sell. You cannot rent a house, rent a car, use the aeroplane, use the train, get food, get water, get the business. You cannot do anything that involves the use of money without having the mark of the beast. And once you take the mark of the beast, you are doomed for eternity in hell. And once you avoid it also, because the new world order and the systems of the Antichrist will be in place, anyone who refuses it will be persecuted, will die, they will cut people's head, they are going to butcher people, they are going to everything they are going to do to cause you to get the mark of the beast, the 666. And if you avoid it, they will torture you to the and may even kill you. But if you refuse to take the mark, you will have eternal life. That will be the only second chance. However, you will be saved by your own works. You have to die for even salvation during that time. That's why today is the time for you to just receive Jesus Christ as a free gift and have eternal life without going through that. And if you avoid or if you are stubborn to refuse Jesus Christ today, then I'm warning you, during the great tribulation, don't take the mark of the beast. Don't take the 666 mark, because once you take it, you are doomed. Some of us cannot even bear persecution in our workplace. Once people begin to persecute us, hey, we want to just keep quiet and no. Some of us cannot bear the simple pressures of life, sickness, pain, and conflict. We can't go through. So do you think that you survive during the great tribulation when they are willing to kill you if you refuse the mark of the beast? Just ask yourself, will you survive? That's why it's important for you to make up your mind today. The choice is yours.